Hey ladies and gentlemen, Steven here from Rata Lessons and welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for joining me today. I really appreciate it and I hope that this video finds you well. So today we're going to be talking about whether or not I think the original Le Mall from the mid-90s by Jean-Paul Gaultier is still worth it 25 years later in 2020. So make sure to stay tuned. Now, before I tell you whether or not I think the original Le Mall by Jean-Paul Gaultier is still worth it in 2020, and this is about 25 years old now, I do want to mention that if you are a fan of fragrance-related content, if you like fragrance reviews here on YouTube, but also top 10 videos, giveaways, unboxings, special guests, interviews, and pretty much anything having to do with fragrances, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. All you have to do is click on that red button in the corner. And of course, while you're at it, please be sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell. This way, whenever I do put out these videos, they will get delivered straight to your feed. So is the original Le Mall by Jean-Paul Gaultier still worth it in the year 2020? So this is a fragrance that came out in the mid-90s. The perfumer is Francis Kurkdjian. He is such an established perfumer. I've actually had the pleasure of meeting him in person several times. He's even done fragrances for Navitus Parfum, the brand of which I am the creative director. And so I have a different relationship with him, but you know, I initially met him in Paramus, New Jersey when he was doing an event at a local mall. And then I also met him in Paris when we had a business meeting back in February of this year, 2020. He's such an incredible individual, one of the best perfumers in the industry, and I have nothing but respect for him. But in today's video, we're going to be questioning the validity of this fragrance in the year 2020. Do I think it's still worth it in 2020? So the first category that I took a look at is the uniqueness. Do I think that this fragrance is still unique in 2020? And what I mean by that is, has there been another fragrance that came out after it that people compared to it that I think is probably a little bit better than it? And this is not talking about alternatives. Alternatives might be inclusive of like clones and stuff like that. But I know a lot of people talk about Reflection Man by Amouage. And so while I do pick up on the similarity between the two, and I really like Reflection Man, which is a composition by Lucas Suzak, despite the differences, I actually feel like Reflection Man smells a lot more bright, a lot more natural. Of course, this has the vanilla, the mint, the lavender, and Reflection Man has a little bit of that lavender fougere thing going on in here, but this fragrance was definitely unique for its time. As much as I prefer to wear Reflection Man, because I think it's a bit more polished, a little bit more of a dressed up and formal scenario kind of a fragrance, I really do like this fragrance, especially for nostalgia reasons. However, in terms of the uniqueness, when this fragrance first came out, it was super unique. Of course, the only other fragrance on the market at the time, at least, as far as I know, is Cuba Gold. I also own that one. I've owned several bottles of that one. Super, super, super cheap, which I think doesn't say a lot for this fragrance if you can go out there and buy Cuba Gold for like, you know, 25% of the price tag of this one. I think that that one is a really good option if we're talking about, you know, financial reasons. But in terms of uniqueness, when it came out, it certainly was unique. But since then, we've had fragrances like Reflection for Men by Amouage that I think is a fantastic fragrance and one that I actually find myself wearing a lot more often than the original Le Mans. So that brings us to my next category, which is alternatives. Do I think that there are some alternatives on the market for this fragrance? And the answer to that is absolutely, right? Cuba Gold is a really inexpensive option for Le Mans. If you want a very, very, very similar DNA, I'm talking about like 95% similar, and you only want to spend like 15 bucks, maybe even less than that. I think I've seen some online in like the $8 range. Cuba Gold will serve you very, very well. But of course, that also goes back to, do you want to smell like a fragrance that came out in the mid-90s? If you're doing it for nostalgia reasons, I'm sure the answer to that question is yes. But Cuba Gold smells very similar. And yes, since then, there have been many clones and many fragrances that kind of create their own version of Le Mans, and they also make it very similar to the original. Now, of course, that also brings us to the integrity of the formula, otherwise known as reformulations. Has this fragrance incurred any reformulations? And the answer to that, unfortunately, is yes. It is no secret. Everybody who talks about Le Mans oftentimes brings up the fact that it's not as strong as it used to be. It doesn't have the same virility. It doesn't have the same substance that it once used to. And so unfortunately, when we're dealing with Le Male, we're dealing with a fragrance that has been weakened quite a bit. And so it's kind of become more airy and watered down, an adulterated version of its former self, which is quite unfortunate, especially for fans of the fragrance. And I actually knew a few people in my life who wore this fragrance and still wear this fragrance religiously. And even they have said it doesn't smell the same, which is not much of a shocker considering how old it is, but it is definitely disappointing. And so I feel like you can probably find some other fragrances out there with a similar DNA that are probably a little bit stronger and might even be a little bit more to your liking. So definitely make sure to hunt around if you are a fan of this one, but you want to smell something that does things a little bit differently, but gives you better performance. And that brings us to the price. Can this be found online for a much cheaper price? The answer to that question is yes, absolutely. This can be found on websites like FragranceNet, FragranceX, Max Aroma, unlike something like a Chanel, where it's super hard to find Chanels online at discounted prices, Jean Paul Gaultier's are found all over the place. And so I would say, do not buy Le Male from Macy's, Sephora, Dillard's, Nordstrom, or any of these other main retailers, because you will find yourself paying MSRP and it's just not worth it, especially if you can save 30 or 40 bucks by buying it online. Yeah, granted, you're probably gonna get stock that is at least 6 months old, but you're still gonna get an authentic product because websites like Max Aroma, FragranceNet, FragranceX, PerfumeOnline.ca, FragranceBuy.ca, all of these companies do have 100% authentic products. And so I would definitely recommend that you search one of those websites first and really compare their prices and see if you can get the best deal on this fragrance. I'm also gonna leave a link down below if you are interested in getting this one for a really, really good price. And you know, I did the research and yes, this can be found discounted online. And then that brings me to the final category, which is the modernity. Is this something that still smells modern in the year 2020 relative to when it was released? Now, despite the fact that this fragrance came out about 25 years ago, I think it still smells a little bit modern. And here's the reason why I don't say it smells fully modern. If you think about fragrances that came out in the past few years, you're probably going to think about fragrances like Versace Dylan Blue. You might think about Dior Sauvage, you might think about this fragrance, and I think we're seeing that a lot of the more modern fragrances have a sweetness to them. Bad Boy by Carolina Herrera, or Invictus Aqua by Paco Rabanne, or 1 Million Parfum by Paco Rabanne, Azzaro Wanted, so on and so forth. These fragrances all smell rather sweet as opposed to this one, which is sweet because it has that vanilla, but it doesn't ever go in this sort of bubblegum territory, which I know is a very weird descriptor, but I don't think that the sweetness of the modern fragrances are akin to the sweetness that is found in this one. So there is a bit of a detachment, and so it doesn't smell, you know, super modern, but it also doesn't smell as antiquated as some fragrances that have an overdose of lavender. This one kind of has that lavender, but it's not like a Zeno by Davidoff or like a Beau de Jour by Tom Ford. It's not within that genre. I think the sweetness really offsets that sort of aggressive and barbershop quality of the lavender. And also, it's not like an overdose of oak moss or fir or pine or anything like that that would make it reminiscent of fragrances that came out in the late 70s and 80s. And so I think it's kind of modern, but not fully modern. So my final verdict, do I think Le Male by Jean Paul Gaultier is still worth it in 2020? Unfortunately, I would have to say no. I think that there are a lot of options out there that are more representative of this time period, which might not be what you're going for. You know, maybe you like some of these old school fragrances, in which case, by all means, please continue to wear it. You know, these are just recommendations. But despite the fact that, yeah, it can be found significantly discounted online, there are a lot of really cheap alternatives like Cuba Gold, where for somebody who really likes the smell, but they want to go for something that's a little more inexpensive, I would always recommend Cuba Gold. And at the end of the day, I feel like Le Male, or Jean Paul Gaultier rather, has put out a lot of really great Le Male flankers, whether we're talking about Ultramal or Le Beau, or even the more recent one. And they're great, you know? I feel like if you like this DNA, you want to smell something a little bit more modern and contemporary, branch out. You know, try some of the other flankers that this company has put out. And I feel like you might eventually find something that is to your satisfaction, but the way that people know Lotus et Pour Homme by Issey Miyake, the way that people know Nautica Voyage, the way that people know Acqua di Gio by Giorgio Armani, people can also recognize this scent. This is such an iconic scent, and it's one that, hey, if you want to have it in your collection for reference purposes, for nostalgia purposes, even for personal taste purposes, by all means, please do. But in terms of it still being worth it in 2020, in terms of the modernity and all of the alternatives that are on the market, I don't think it's still worth it in 2020. But of course, that leaves me with the question, do you think this fragrance is still worth it in 2020? If you do, let me know, leave a comment down below. I always appreciate the interaction. And once again, I want to say, if you are new to this channel and you took something of value from this video, I would appreciate it so much if you would consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. All you have to do is click on that red button in the corner. And of course, while you're at it, please be sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell. Thanks again for watching. I love you all. We'll see you next time. Bye.